Dan here from mathforlove.com with a quick math conversation challenge for you at home. And it is this. Whatever problem you're working on, even a very simple naked arithmetic problem like 23 minus 9, instead of just coming up with the answer, which in that case would be 14, maybe you know the algorithm and you do it that way and then you'd be done. Instead of doing that, with your child, come up with as many ways as you can to find the answer. Maybe you say, well, 23 minus 9 is the same as 24 minus 10, because I can always move both of them up one, be the same difference between them. And I can do that more easily because I know how to subtract 10. Maybe you subtract 10 and then add 1 back in, and that's the same as subtracting 9. Maybe you draw 23 circles and then cross off 9 of them. Maybe you think of 9 as 6 plus 3. You're going to subtract the 3 to get from 23 to 20, then subtract the 6 to get down to 14. Maybe you'll actually think of the 23 as being 10 and 10 and 3, and you'll just subtract the 9 from one of the 10s, and you'll have 10 minus 9 is 1, so now it's 1 and 10 and 3, and that's 14. Any way you do it is a valuable way to approach it, but what's most important here is that if you just have one way to do things, it's very fragile. If you make some little mistake or forget something, you're lost. Real, robust mathematical understanding comes from having lots of different ways to attack problems and understanding the connections between them. So you can have a very productive math conversation at home today and every day just by saying, well, let's not stop at one answer. Let's see just how many approaches we can get to find the answer to this problem. Good luck.